Welcome to SF Liberal Buzz. We're glad you tuned in. Lots of has happened in the cannabis community, and we're going to be reporting on that today. Eli was up at the state building and has a lot to talk about. And we're going to show you some videos. If we have time for them, it could take up the whole show with just showing the videos. But
very informative tonight.
So we had 20 people go up in a bus, and they had a lot to tell the lawmakers up there. They went to Tom Amiano's office. And which other office did you go to?
We went to for Life and Neck, and I remember exactly who. Forgive me, please.
You're cool.
I will come back to that in a moment. I'll try to remember exactly who. I had it written down, but I cannot find the exact paperwork written down who exactly we visited. But I'll come back to that. So
we're going
to
zip through my Twitter feed, and you can follow me or Eli at Elu 2001 or
here's
me, Denise Story.
And here's me.
Well, you know, he's not Denise, so. Anyway, well, you could be. It'd be cool.
No, you'd be Denise, I'd be the nephew.
Okay. Hey, that'd be fun. That'd be even more fun. Okay. So on Twitter, I haven't really done the Twitter feed in a couple weeks, so. Oh, actually, it's been over about a month, so. Some cannabis strains. Oh, yeah. Some cannabis strains are like coffee, while others promote sleep. And Alec is concerned about corruption, folks. They're not concerned about unfair taxing or any of that. They're just more concerned about unfair. The people. They think that the people are after them. So, and we are. So anyway. Proposed California Senate bill promises elite cannabis industrial oligarchy and excludes patient collectives. So as it goes now, the patient collectives we're going to be stuck with a couple people writing all the rules, and we'll get to that later. And ignorant sycophants cannot value liberty or freedom while supporting cannabis prohibition. Cannabinoids act as antioxidants and neuroprotectants. That's a good article. You might want to check it out. And the country really is progressive, so there's that. And let's see, the soccer stadium, that's going to be something we're going to cover upcoming. And the federal marijuana bill would legalize some cannabis strains and while keeping others illegal. How Rupert Murdoch pushed Australia into a climate change retreat. And you can go back and see our last show with Shona. Nestle's CEO. We have a lot of things on Twitter. You can look at our Axis of Love shows. We're on there. So I'm going to go to Eli's Twitter so we can get through that. I've taken up 3 minutes, and you can take up as long as you like.
Okay, cool. We're first going to start off talking about, this is going to be another topic in the show here. Berkeley is demanding MCDs give compassion to all patients. This is the topic we're going to be talking about here.
Oh, right. Yeah, 2%.
Yes. I tweeted, I can't even talk tonight. I tweeted this because Denise was in Oakland, and she told us the BART train stopped due to a possible fire. A's fans were stuck downtown Oakland because there's a lot of funny smell.
Ozone.
In the train.
Smelled like electrical.
Like electrical fire?
It was gaggy, choky. Gaggy, choky.
And this little article right here is very interesting. The U.S. government wants to sue Obama for doing his job. Well, they should at least be sued for shutting down the government itself. And of course, we have more political news here. North Korea actually does threaten a nuclear strike on the White House. Was it the fifth or sixth time this year they've done that? Of course. And of course, I'm going to talk about the Middle East here. I can't believe I'm tweeting this here. Israel needs to talk to Sheriff Joe Arpaio on how to deal with tunnels and no civilian deaths. If you're unfamiliar with Joe Arpaio, he's America's famous toughest, roughest sheriff. You can ask more about him if you have a talk with George Gascon. Joe Arpaio deals with these tunnels in Arizona, Mexican border, for drug trafficking and smuggling, human trafficking and smuggling. He closes down these tunnels and no civilian deaths. This is something Israel should actually look at. And this is, of course, the Giants lost, and I was upset, yes, of course. If you're still unaware, there is a woman who is 98 years old, and she is facing eviction.
Oh.
If this article pull up, I will show you exactly what I'm talking about. Or you can always go to my Twitter feed and look it up yourself.
I read about it.
This is very unjust right here. This is a petition.
Oh.
Yes, I know. The tenants can stay, but attorney, look at this. Housing Rights Committee wants to save Mary and Sarah's homes. Oh. Please call 970-920-2112 to help stop these unlawful Ellis Act evictions. Okay? The Ellis Act basically itself just needs to be repelled.
Go to his Twitter feed and check out how you can do that.
And WTFX, did you know the actual color of the universe is cosmic latte?
Kind of brownish.
Yeah, it is kind of a brownish, but that's the official color of the cosmos.
The color of dust. If you have dust bunnies.
Yeah, dust bunnies, hey. Ron Guerin, astronaut aboard the ISS, took some pictures right here of the rockets firing from Israel and Palestine and West Bank. These lines right here, these are rocket trails. This is one of the saddest photos he has said he's ever taken from space. I know, it's very, very sad. Too many deaths. Yes, you can tell I am a Giants fan here. And I have to promote my friend Greg Proops. He was in San Francisco last week, a couple weeks ago. Making fun of my friend Joya here. She's a vegetarian. I have no hard hill against vegetarians. It's just I prefer eating something that used to have a face. That's just me. Very funny here, the LA Memorial Tree Day Kid to George Harrison is actually being eaten by beetles, believe it or not. You want to be more? Yes. And there were 72 people murdered in one neighborhood in Gaza. Neil Armstrong went on the moon on July 20, 1969. And hey, on the way, Buzz did see a UFO. Of course, NASA basically just disregarded all that. More Magaza stuff, and very funny, Church of God, Zilla, in Washington, Zilla, Washington. I'm not sure who actually worships there, many Japanese probably.
Oh.
Enter the snare drum, ba-doom bum. U.S. has issued new sanctions against Russia. In response, Russia will ban American visas. This means any American citizen traveling to Russia will be not allowed. Of course, the news today is Edward Snowden has been given a 3-year visa extension in Russia today.
Well, they're also teaming up with Iran, too, Russia is.
Well, here's the good news about Edward Snowden in Russia. His extension allows him to travel, which means he can actually get out of Russia and go to where he originally wanted, so he doesn't have to be stuck in a backward country.
Okay, well, Assange is stuck in the Ecuadorian embassy for time immemorial. Probably never get out of there.
Exactly. And of course, we have the 5% Compassionate Coalition ask, and I can't even spell, I forgot the P, ask to include the 5% mandatory compassion in the San Francisco
Thanks
law.
Thanks for retweeting that for me.
Oh, it's no problem. I had to let people know this. People suffer. Berkeley did the, Berkeley recently got 5%.
And they have less disabled folks than.
Exactly.
We have more young people that
college. As you can see, the title here says Free Pot for the Poor. Berkeley wants to give away free pot. Why? Because low-income patients cannot afford it. So you see, free. Look at this. What are we doing?
We've been trying to do that since 2007. We got Ross Marini to make a... We were going to have a binding resolution, but then the industry got in and made it non-binding. So that it wasn't a requirement, but we had this was our idea in 2007, but we didn't have a progressive enough government to actually implement it because the industry was giving them money. And stuff.
I believe this was called Proposition S.
It wasn't a proposition. It was a resolution.
Ah, resolution.
It was a resolution by Ross Marini in early 2007, late 2006.
This is something we talked about when we decided to go to the state capitol on
yes.
Tuesday. If anybody's unaware, there's a bill called SB
1262.
Yes. This totally dismantles SB 420. Denise, would you like to explain
yes,
to the viewers what SB 420 is?
SB 420 allows collectives and people to grow medicine for each other. Now they want to cut it down to only 5 people can grow per garden. things like that, where we were having a lot of people per garden because a lot of people need it, and most people can't grow, and it's a, and even and they wanted to charge $8,000.
Actually, there's a correction to that. It's not exactly $8,000. It's up to $8,000.
Yeah, that's the max. Well,
here's the
catch. They want to combine the industry with medical in one branch of government. They want to create a branch of government to govern both the medical cannabis and the recreational industry.
Here's the catch of this. It's not up to $8,000 for the license. It's up to $8,000 also for the growing, for the transportation, for the two employees it's going to be transportation, for the basically for the cultivators, for the ones who are actually cooking.
And they'll be using that money to police us. So, and if people are going to jail, is it really legal? If people want, you know, if people want to grow in their backyard, they have to pay $8,000, you know, up to $8,000. Maybe they were talking about sliding scales.
This is what we're asking for, basically sliding scales. Let me brief you on this. We're basically asking for a commercial license for provisional licenses to at least have a compassionate discount prices. Say, for instance, you are applying for an MCD in any one state of California. Well, how about a discount if you decide to offer compassion to low-income or veterans or disabled patients? If you do not, you pay full price. This is a way to get MCDs to actually comply with, hey, there are low-income patients out there who cannot afford medication.
And the Board of Equalization, we're taxing cannabis dispensaries on 100% of their cannabis, whether they sold it or gave it away.
Oh, excuse me.
So.
Ribbit. Yep, frog in my throat.
So that was an issue, too, that we deal with. Now, Shona was talking about that on a previous show. Mm-hmm. The last show we were talking, it was right at the end, so we had to cut it off.
We also talked about...
the bill's going to be heard next Wednesday.
Yes, next Wednesday, because they decided to change it on the way to Sacramento. We also decided to ask for a certain panel probe. Every single policy has a panel which members of these certain areas usually sit on it, correct?
Yes.
Well, we're asking for at least one patient and one police officer to sit on this panel. Why a patient and police officer? Because the patient actually deals with this directly, and the police officer can actually say, hey, this is what we're doing on our side of the law. So we have both sides of the panel, and so it's just not forward with business owners, business owners, business owners, business owners, business owners, business owners. It's actually a patient and a cop will be involved in this process.
And there's closed meetings now.
We want to strike that. It's actually against the law to have a closed meeting.
It is.
That's why we want to strike that, yeah.
They had one during the Ed Rosenthal trial. They had it closed. So look how that turned out.
And there is talk about there being a California cannabis czar. Do you know what this is? Someone who regulates the sales, distribution, everything that has to do with the cannabis and medical cannabis in California. I believe that Lieutenant Governor Gavin Newsom is trying to implement this plan in City, California.
He was good on issues sometimes.
He was very good on issues. I just hopefully, if he does decide to do this, Lieutenant Governor, if you are watching or somebody knows who's watching, please remember, protect patients' rights.
Yeah,
whoever is the California czar.
Email or call them.
Please protect patient rights. That's all we ask of you.
Jerry Brown was all about, in 2008 or 2009, one of those 2 years, I think it was 2008, he implemented the patients' collectives.
Mm-hmm.
So you could patients could collectively grow. So I don't know where that's going to go. Now I guess they're going to...
He did make a statement about legalizing, and I think it was MSNBC report, I cannot remember exactly who, just tried to change the word from potted to drunks, and the same thing applied. Basically, Moonbeam Brown is talking to certain people that he should not be talking to.
Oh, man.
And actually not listening to patients.
Oh.
The people actually affect about this. Because there are patients who can take Vicodin, who can take Oxycontins, but yet they're high and they're out of pain. Medical cannabis, there's certain strains where you do not get high, you just get well.
That was in my Twitter. Mm-hmm. Some are just like drinking a cup of coffee. There's pot that's no stronger than coffee. Actually, coffee is probably stronger. So
especially Cuban coffee. Sorry, you know my weakness now.
So the bill will go up, what, August the 15th?
It's scheduled to be heard next Wednesday.
Oh, Wednesday, so that's the 13th.
Oh, Tuesday, sorry, next Tuesday.
12th. Yeah, so, and the law enforcement is calling the shots on this, and they don't expect the bill to actually go any, they're going to try to revise it, and if it's not revised, it's going to die, and nothing will come out until next year when Tom Amiano's gone. And Tom Amiano was supposed to be the so-called expert on the cannabis issues.
Assemblymember Amiano has rejected patients' requests, and
well, he tiptoed away in the video. You put the camera on him and he tiptoed away because I watched the video you took up there.
Yeah, that was very interesting. We was at Amiano's office and we was talking to his legislative aide, and Assemblymember Amiano walks up to us and Shona said, "Tom, come talk to us. We're talking about cannabis." And Assemblymember Amiano just walked directly into his office, totally avoided us. On his way out, he could at least acknowledge us, said hi. There was no acknowledgement from Assemblymember Amiano, which I'm very upset because I did vote for you.
Lots of us did. A lot of progressives often vote for against their own best interests, even sometimes, because he wasn't all there for us.
I've had a history dealing with politicians, and either if they're negative, if they're for us or against us, they at least acknowledge us. Tom did not even say hi or wave. He just walked right on by.
It's about the scratch. I think. I mean, I've heard it. You know, a little birdie told me standing on the grapevine that something about money. So, when money's involved, things don't go right for us, and it just seems to. History seems to repeat itself over and over. It did in 2007. It did when we had the David Campos got the cannabis task force going for us, and the industry got into that and stopped. Everything we tried to do for patients to get us medicine without, we were trying to get it written into law somehow to get some kind of medicine for patients. That's what Axis of Love has gone to bat for since I've been a member in 2006. And we've gotten non-binding resolutions from Ross Mercurimi when he was supervisor, but that's the best we've really been able to do. Now I wish Shona would call in. She's out taking care of her rent.
Her personal business.
And you know, she pays rent for the office, and it's not cheap. I mean, we have to get donations for that. And next time she'll probably be in soon, so you can actually tweet her. She's got Twitter, Axis of Love SF, and talk if you have any questions about it to her.
All you can do is check out one of our Twitter accounts. You can follow who follows us. We follow you.
Yeah.
Follow me and I'll follow you back.
Yeah, I was going to
follow me on Twitter. Okay, I'm not a stalker.
I was going to show some YouTube videos, but we basically covered most of what they said verbally just now.
There's one thing that's lacking from this whole entire bill of SB 62. There's no minimum standard of care for medical cannabis in California right now.
No, they wanted to propose it.
And this is what we're trying to do. We're trying to at least get a minimum standard of care. Because I remember several years ago
a uniform minimum standard.
I remember several years ago when I was working in the shelter system, shelter employees did not treat any of the residents with dignity and respect. When I helped write that law, I made sure that the first thing on that law was all clients treated with dignity and respect. This should be at least part of every single basic standard care.
Well, they're not really thinking of it. It's police are writing these rules.
The federal government,
Shona's mentioned that the federal government would be fining California if we didn't, if we just stuck with the laws we have now, which are SB 420 and
yes, well, unfortunately, SB 1262,
which is
overriding it.
Well, we need, and what about, there might be a voter-approved initiative coming out soon, too, in 2016. We were going to try to get it on for the ballot this November, but it didn't quite wash.
Yeah, come on, San Francisco. DC beat us to it.
We didn't get the
Berkeley beat us to it.
We didn't get enough signatures on that. So, or it just they didn't have it together enough. We covered it on an earlier show. So maybe there will be a voter initiative, and I hope it won't be industry written, so that it'll include patients. We've got to have our input heard. Because it's about the patients, and for people to be making money off of cannabis dispensaries, they need to pay attention to the whole reason why.
The pharmaceutical industry is already making money off of their products with their patients, so and they're already protected. So why can't the cannabis community be protected?
And the U.S. government holds a patent to cannabis.
Mm-hmm. It does. So,
Yeah, there's that. And there, and the revisions, they said, would be to our liking in the Senate bill, getting back to the Senate bill, about the driving thing. They want to make it, even though you didn't smoke weed 24 days, if it'll be in your fat, it stores itself in the fat cells, and it you can test positive up to 90 days after smoking.
Actually, it's 45. Up to 45? Yes.
Really, is it 45?
That's
still a long time.
If you get into an accident or another circumstance with the police in your vehicle, and they decide to do a test for cannabis, and you test positive, although you did not smoke, if you stated,
right.
You can get your license revoked, or points, major points taken off your license. You can get a car impounded, jail time, and or possible a fine.
Treated like boozers, basically. So, and even though cannabis isn't really proven to be worse than alcohol for driving impairment, it depends on the strain. Again, some strains are like drinking coffee, and some strains make you want to sleep.
And each person's metabolism is different.
Yes.
One person can handle one beer, one person can handle 15 beers.
And eating a candy bar will make you come down. off of all the cannabis, sometimes the sugar just negates all the psychoactive effects of cannabis. That's hardly ever mentioned. Sugar just...
And like I said, everybody's metabolism is different. So.
Yes, that too. And so we hope that they don't eliminate backyard grows. It's, you know, there's going to all these permit fees are going to be to police.
And these collectives
people.
Are going to be effective. MCDs are going to be effective because
yes.
The current ones actually help patients rely on some of these private grows. They, hey, well, I'm going to donate some of this to dispensary so they can get to some actual patients.
They won't be able to without paying a lot of money. So
well, we have
already,
a show.
They already pay taxes.
We have a show in 2 weeks. Don't forget to buy a street sheet.
Yeah, street sheet. And we've got a pre-recorded episode of Let's Talk Sports next. Please adopt a shelter pet. Dog and cat or dog or cat are waiting for you, and maybe even other types of animals too. And check out Axis of Love show on Friday at 6 p.m. We'll cover all these topics then.